me, frankly speaking. You know, I don't believe I belong there at all. So, you know, I am always, almost always in agreement with my government, but not necessarily all the time.
Al-Waleed bin Talal is a Saudi businessman, investor, philanthropist, and Saudi family member. In 2008, he appeared on the yearly list of the 100 most important people in the world in Time magazine. Al-Waleed is the grandson of Abdulaziz, the first Saudi king, the nephew of all subsequent Saudi kings, and the grandson of Lebanon's first prime minister. Al-Waleed bin Talal is one of the wealthiest people in the Middle East, and he's proven that he is more than his cash and opulent lifestyle. At an early age, this person was renowned by his real estate company, Kingdom Holding Company, in the Middle Eastern nation. He went into the financial sector and got linked with multi-billion dollar companies such as Citicorp. He is the founder, CEO, and 95% owner of Kingdom Holding Corporation, a company that invests in financial services, tourism and hospitality, mass media, entertainment, retail, agribusiness, petrochemicals, aviation, technology, and real estate. The corporation has more than $18 billion in market capitalization in 2013, the second largest voting shareholder in 21st Century Fox, and a smaller stakeholder in Zabarawala Holdings. The Paris Four Seasons Hotel, George V, are owners of the Al-Waleed, Citigroup's largest individual shareholder and part of Plaza Hotel. He was the Arab Warren Buffett by his successors. He also went on to invest in numerous well-known companies, including computer genius Steve Jobs, Apple Inc., AOL, and other hotel behemoths. This business honcho began to be an active part of charitable initiatives at a later point in his life, which included empowering Saudi Arabian women, granting scholarships and poverty reduction. He's also spent a great deal of money for the restoration of natural catastrophes like the tsunami generously. In pursuit of his ambition of an aircraft flight, he even encouraged one woman called Zakara Al-Hindi because of the significant aid from Waleed. The woman became Saudi Arabia's first female pilot.
Attention, they were still functioning. And there is a blessing in disguise, really. It was a conclusive proof that all these operations, they were functioning as normal as possible, even in my absence.
If you enjoy these videos, please remember to hit the like button, as it does help us out a lot. And comment below who your favorite celebrity is that you'd love to see in an upcoming video. His full name is Al-Waleed bin Talal Al-Saud, but is also known as Al-Waleed. He was born on March 7, 1955 in Jeddah, Saudi Arabia, making him 66 at the time of this production. He stands 168 centimeters or 5 feet 8 inches tall. On November 4, 2017, Al-Waleed was detained in Saudi Arabia as part of a new Royal Anti-Corruption Committee's cleansing of illegal behavior. Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman, his cousin, gave his approval. Al-Waleed allegedly contacted journalist Jamal Khashoggi, who has previously openly discussed the Saudi government just days before his arrest, inviting him to return to the kingdom and contribute to Mohammed bin Salman's vision. It was rumored that Prince Al-Waleed was planning his own succession to the throne, backed by a number of other powerful royals, all of whom are now in prison. Al-Waleed has been working actively in the charity work as he established his own foundation. He has stated that he will donate his whole $32 billion fortune to his foundation over the next several years. Al-Waleed said in a statement that he would begin transferring his wealth to Al-Waleed Philanthropies, which he already has donated $3.5 billion to in support of charitable projects, with the goal of creating a better world of tolerance, acceptance, equality, and opportunity for all. And that his commitment without boundaries, the foundation seeks to build a more tolerant and welcoming world by promoting more sustainable communities, empowering women and youth, assisting catastrophe survivors, and promoting more tolerant and welcoming societies. The prince will be the chairman of the board of trustees responsible with spending the assets, which will be given for humanitarian projects and initiatives after his death. In 1991, Prince Al-Waleed bin Talal purchased Donald Trump's boat. Talal tweeted Trump in June 2016, saying he would never win the presidential election and that he should get out. He was also quoted as stating Trump was a disgrace to America, but after Trump was elected, he reversed his position and congratulated him on his victory on Twitter. Al-Waleed has had 4 marriages. According to another account, he has been married 7 times. At the age of 19, he married for the first time in 1976. His first wife was King Saud's daughter, Dalal bint Saud, who was his cousin. They divorced in December 1994 after having two children, Prince Khaled, born on April 21, 1978, and Princess Reem, born June 20, 1982. Al-Waleed married Princess Iman Sudaira in 1996, however, the marriage only lasted about a year. Al-Waleed married Khalud al-Anazi in 1999 after divorcing his second wife. In 2004, they divorced. Amira al-Tawil was his fourth wife and they divorced in 2014 after around 6 years of marriage. He added in an interview, "Yes, for the first time, I'm announcing it in the Saudi Gazette. I've officially broken up with Princess Amira al-Tawil, but I still hold her in the highest regard."
Kit is very transparent. So please, you can go to the list of holdings and you look there, how much is my holding there? You know, you can see it's 95%.
Prince Al-Waleed bin Talal, a Saudi Arabian financier, is a descendant of the Saudi royal family. He's the son of Talal bin Abdulaziz Al Saud and was born in March 1955. He's also Saudi King Salman's half-brother and the grandson of Ibn Saud, the country's founder and first ruler. Mona al-Sul, the daughter of Lebanon's first prime minister, Riyad al-Sul, was his mother. Prince Al-Waleed bin Talal studied in the United States for his post-secondary studies. He graduated from Menlo College in California with a BA in Business Administration and Syracuse University in New York with an MA in Social Sciences. In 1979, Prince Al-Waleed bin Talal established the Kingdom Establishment for Commerce and Trade. Profits from the initial successful transactions were invested in the Riyadh real estate market, laying the groundwork for KHC's future prosperity. In 1988, Prince Al-Waleed's business purchased a majority position in the United Saudi Commercial Bank, which was experiencing financial difficulties at the time. The bank became one of Saudi Arabia's most successful commercial banks in under 12 months. In 1999, the Saudi Cairo Bank, the Saudi American Bank, and the United Saudi Commercial Bank merged to become one of the region's most powerful financial empires. Prince Al-Waleed invested in Citibank in 1991, and the bank's finances improved dramatically. Prince Al-Waleed owns shares in Citigroup, Twitter, Apple, Time Warner, Four Seasons Hotel and Resorts, the Hotel George V in Paris, and the Savoy Hotel in London, as well as real estate, health, fashion, and a variety of other businesses. He's also a member of the Breakthrough Energy Coalition and the Rotana Group, which is the largest industrial corporation in the Arab world. Prince Al-Waleed bin Talal has won several decorations, medals, and decorations, including the Baden-Powell Medal from Sweden, 2013, the Hungarian Order of Merit Middle Cross, 2014, and Grand Officer of the Order of Leopold from Belgium, 2014. In 2014, the Arabian Business magazine named Talal first among the world's most powerful Arabs. In the same year, he was named the world's 50 most influential Arabs by Middle East magazine. In addition, he was included among the top 20 billionaires in Bloomberg's 2014 Billionaires Index.
After I left, we were back in communication, you know, with the King's office, with the Crown Prince and his people. And that's a very strange situation, by the way, not easy.
His income is not yet estimated, but he is one of the richest Arabs in the world. When Forbes estimated his net worth in 2014, which was $18 billion, he filed a lawsuit for underestimating his empire. Now his net worth is estimated to be $22 billion. He has three palaces ranging from 250,000 to 4 million square meters. Two of these palaces, Kingdom Resort and Kingdom Palace, are in the city of Hai Al Huda. Kingdom Oasis's third and largest palace is in Jinadria. Al-Waleed owns several cars, a Rolls-Royce Diamond, a Mercedes SL 600 Diamond White, a Mercedes SL 600 Diamond Gold, and a GMC Savannah van. Prince Al Waleed owns the 54th largest private yacht in the world.